And Arsenal, well, they needed that. There you go, up to ninth, back up into the top half of the table, as Darren said, above their North London rivals, which they will love. Only 3 points behind the defending champions, but still 8 points off finishing in the top four. Leicester stay third, and there is still that nice buffer between them and slipping your way on Tuesday evening. It's called ours.
For everyone, two consecutive victories now, a really important one in the Premier League as well. What does that do for the mood in the team?
It's really good. We want to come back at the top of the league as higher as possible. We know we had to do some win consecutive to come back. And today we really wanted to win and we did it well, I think.
What was the best part of your performance today as a team?
The reaction after the goal we conceded. Everyone keep the focus. We stay with the game plan. And when everyone is like this, it's easier to win games.
You, of course, scored today. Pepe and David Luiz as well. Willian put in a good performance. How important is it for the senior players in the squad to be stepping up at key moments like this in the season, where this is going to really define your season from now?
I think it's important that everyone's play well. Recently, we talk a lot about the youngest who play really, really well, who have the team, but as well as senior player, we need to be ready, to be good. We don't have to play to rely only on the youngs, obviously. So when everyone is focused and good, it's easier for Arsenal.
Do you guys have that in your minds when you come out to play?
Yeah, we need to play. We need to play well. Everyone wants to play, so they have to be really... We have to perform really well to show to the coach that we deserve, and after is to the coach to decide.
Mikel Arteta said after the victory over Benfica last Thursday that win really kept your season alive. Is that how it feels today, that now that you've finally got that victory again in the Premier League, that taste of victory, it's going to be really important going into this really important period of the season now?
Yeah, we know it's really important now. We have March, April and May to finish well. I think this win is going to give a lot of confidence for the team because we came back from losing games, so it's good for the team, for the spirit, for the mood, for everything.
Thank you very much,
Alexander.
Thank
you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah, well played, that man today. He's quite right when Reshman asks him what's the most important moment today, coming back from going a goal down, and it's the second time they've done it in a week.
Great character, you know, great desire. You see him for we'll see it later for the third goal, the desire of Cedric to run on the outside, on the overlap. So the whole performance, great character, and they deserve the win. You know, had more attempts than Leicester, more possession Leicester. Very good performance.
Yeah, we can see the goal that took Leicester into the lead here today. And we have to remember, this is an Arsenal team fighting back who didn't get back from their European trip until late on Friday. I know Leicester obviously had a busy week as well. It tells you a lot, dealing with these games after European nights are big.
Yeah, it was poor defensively from Arsenal, and then he's got to get across. Murray's got to get across. You know, great strike from Tielemans across the goalkeeper. You know, see here, Mari's got to get out there. First and foremost, I think Elneny, as the defensive midfield player, had to get across much earlier. But it was a great strike. The goalkeeper, no chance across him. It was a great start from Leicester City.
Yeah, and if there were question marks over the defending there, no question marks from the defender who got the equaliser.
Yeah, the run, just, you know, the run at the back, poor zonal marking for Leicester. Brave as well. Look at that. It was Ndidi's foot who was coming towards David Luiz's head, but just a little movement. Castagne just for a split second, fine margin, loses him there. And then it's a great header into that far corner. Schmeichel, no chance, and that was a great comeback.
In that situation, is David Luiz waiting for the defender to look at him and then look away before he makes his move?
He's probably looking at Willian. I don't know if Willian's just put into an area or maybe they've worked on it, because you can see that the zonal marking. So David Luiz being clever, he only needs a split second, and the delivery from Willian, if they've looked at each other, who does the pass come first or does the run come first?
So it's more about the ball coming in rather than Castagne's look and waiting for him to look away.
I would say probably David Luiz is moving with Willian, the connection, the eye contact between those two, you know, and that's obviously caught Castagne off guard.
Interesting. And then just a few minutes later, 6 or so minutes later, Arsenal were in the lead. Very impressive from VAR today. Two big decisions. They got them both right. This was the second one, and it was the right call.
Yeah, it was. The handball from Ndidi. You see his arms in an unnatural position. Caught him on the elbow. His arms in the box. So, correct decision. No doubt about it. See, there. And then, obviously, Lacazette. It was a fantastic penalty. Obviously, Paul Tini had to go to the monitor. Correct decision. But the way he just whipped it in that far corner, Schmeichel, no chance. You know, just on the stroke of half-time as well, going in at the break at 2-1 was very good for Arsenal.
And then it was Leicester making a change at half-time. It was Leicester, actually, who came out and were pressing Arsenal straight away. They looked full of intent, but at 3-1, you could see the sort of the bubble burst for Leicester.
Yeah, you know, the energy, players going off, but I think Johnny Evans has to be stronger. You know, I noticed in the second minute, Jake, Johnny Evans wasn't right. I'm not sure if he's carrying an injury. But then just look at the runner, Cedric, on the overlap. Thought Pepe was very good for Arsenal today. Willian, a bit of luck there, I think, goes through. I think it's Tiedemann's legs, but you've got to credit Arsenal. The desire to get forward. What's this runner, Cedric, Jay? Just causes Leicester's, you know, back four just to shuffle over,
right,
which allows Willian the space for Willian. As he goes, just goes through the legs there, and then it's a simple tapping. But they deserve that goal. Ødegaard's pass, the instinctive awareness, yeah, and no. You know, one touch and another touch. Arsenal very good today.
Yep, three goals on Thursday night, three goals on Sunday lunchtime. Let's get the thoughts of Mikel Arteta, who's seen his side win twice in the last 3 days. Here he is.
Mikel, congratulations on the victory. The team showed so much character against Benfica on Thursday and equally the same amount of character today to come from a goal down and then dominate the performance until the end. How pleased are you to get what you spoke to me about pre-match, those two consecutive victories?
Well, I'm really, really proud of the team. The character that we showed, the personality that we played, how we reacted after a disappointment start again when we conceded the goal really early, because it puts against this team in the worst scenario, because that's the game that they want to have a space to run in behind. But then we look composed, we look confident, the energy and the positiveness around the team was really good, and we created some good moments, scored some good goals, and I think overall we deserve to win.
Yeah, because you made six changes today, which did raise a few eyebrows. I know you had to because of the European game. And there was a lot of creative play as well going forward, really playing on that front foot, which is usually what Leicester do. So you were able to completely nullify them. Have you sort of found your system now? Because you played with the back four today. Is that how, what seems to work for this profile
of players?
Depends
the players that we have available, the play, the moment that the team is leaving, and obviously the game plan that we want to produce against certain opponents. But it's not that we have to rotate. I want to rotate and I want to have the chance to the players, because they deserve the way they train every day, how they are all the time behind the players that are playing. And the only way to do it is to play them. You can use any word to motivate a player, but at the end they have to be in the field. And I'm so pleased that even making a lot of changes, we were able to produce this performance.